whatever you're working out on, and have your body on the mat. We're gonna start with a core warm-up. Hands behind the head. We're gonna lift our right foot just an inch to start to work on the pelvis and the stability of the pelvis. We're gonna do abdominal flexion and avoid rotation at the hip. Exhale, three more, inhale to lower. Go with the girls with that breathing. On the exhale, lift. You wanna exhale on that exertion and exhale, lift. Now put that left leg down, pick up the right just an inch, don't lift it too high, and exhale, lift and lower. Exhale, lift, keep that foot really close to the ground. Exhale, lift, avoid rotation in a nice neutral pelvis. Exhale, lift and lower both feet. Now with an imprint, we're gonna challenge with both legs off the ground. Hold that flexion and hold for four, both feet off the ground, two, one. Lower back down. We'll do it again. Imprint, we'll hold for about four counts. It's hold, hold, two, one. Lower back down. We've got two more. These are pretty challenging and warms up your core. And hold, imprint that spine, two, and one, just about four counts each time. Last time, and lift those feet. Hold that flexion, two, and one. Lower back down. Now take your arm out to the side. That same leg's gonna cross over and those legs are gonna come into tabletop. Give you a nice stretch in that glute and a strength in your abdominals. Now we're gonna twist up and over and then all the way down. Three more, up and over and all the way down. Exhale when you lift, inhale when you lower. Exhale when you lift, inhale when you lower. Stay here, tap your leg down. Both of your legs will go towards the ground and then a nice tight lift and down. And then draw it back in and down and up. If you need to modify, drop your head. Go ahead with and, that's perfect. And now both of those together. Let's twist up and over and tap it down. Three more. Twist, return, tap down, relift. Two and tap, lift. Last one and tap and lift. Return those feet and we'll switch the sides. Opposite hand behind the head, opposite arm out wide to the side and cross that same leg over, legs up in the air. Four times. Twist up and return. Up and return. Two more. Return. Last one. Here goes those taps. If you need to rest your head down, go ahead with Anne and tap down and relift. Tap down and relift. Two more. Tap down and relift. One more. Tap and lift. Combo move. Twist. Return. It's tap to lift. Nice job. It's twist. Return. It's tap and lift. Hold those abs in tight. Return. Tap. One more. Twist. Return. It's tap and lift. Bring those legs to tabletop. If you ever need to put your legs down, go ahead. But otherwise, keep them bent or for a challenge, straighten them up. Let's go slow one time. You're gonna take one leg and bring it towards you in a scissor while we're doing a reverse abdominal lift. So let's bring our right leg towards us, hip, lift, right leg towards us, and then the right leg goes long and lean. Maintain that imprint. Now we pull the left leg in, left towards us, and then the left goes long. Keep your knees bent for a modification if you need. So we're gonna do four on each side and a little challenge on that last rep. Ready? Bring that right leg towards you and long. Left towards you and long. Right towards you and long. Left towards you and long. Two more, right towards you and long. Left towards you and long. Here's that challenge. Right towards you. Now hold here for four, three, two, one. Now left leg towards you and lower it down and hold for four, three, two, and one. Bring those legs to tabletop. And if you don't need to rest your legs, keep them up. If you do, put them down for a moment and join us when you're ready. So here, keep your head down, your hands down by your sides. Take your legs on a long diagonal away from you and rotate them. Don't cross your leg over though, keep them open. Draw it back in. Exhale, twist and draw it back in. Don't lean with that upper body, it's twist. and draw it back in. It's that lower abdominal doing all that work while that upper body stays nice and stable. Exhale and draw it in. Exhale and draw it in. Let's make sure we have it. One more. Exhale and draw it back in. And exhale. Making it a little bit harder. Flex the abdominals and twist and draw. Pick up that speed. We'll get that heart rate up. Draw it back in so that you make sure you burn lots of calories and sweat. And two more. We can do it. I know it's challenging. It's two more each side. Draw it back in. Two. One more. It's one. And one. Hold those legs into tabletop. Curl your knees and your upper body together as tight as you can hold it for four. Three. Breathe. Two. And one. Return it back down. Return those feet too. Grab your yoga block that's near you. Scoot down so your feet are on the floor. And the yoga block goes between your knees. Hands down by your sides. We've got to warm up your glutes and strengthen your low back. Squeeze the glutes, lift the hips, and bridge the hips up. Lower back down. Squeeze that yoga block, working that inner thigh. Exhale, lift. Lower back down. Exhale to lift. And lower. Last one. Lift. Squeeze those glutes. And lower. I believe in the one leg bridge, the one leg squat to challenge that glute. So straighten out that opposite leg, squeeze that yoga block, don't let that leg drop. And eight reps here, lift and lower. Exhale and lower. Exhale, lower. Make sure your leg's at a right angle and lower. Four more, it's up. Keep that opposite leg at that same height and really long and straight. And lift. One more, right ladies? How are we doing? All right, let's switch our sides. I hope you're doing okay at home. Ready, eight reps. It's lift and lower. And if you need a break, just pause us. Come back when you're ready. Make sure to drink, exhale. We're gonna just keep going here. Exhale, ready, four more. It's four, return. Exhale, do you feel the glutes? Exhale and last one and return. Lower that foot down. We can put that yoga block down. We're gonna go ahead and lie onto the belly. Here, we're gonna put our right hand behind the head and the left hand fingertips in front of the eyebrows. So we're gonna hover off the ground. We're gonna reach the arms to a T-shape. A little bit of coordination. We're gonna switch which one's in front. Switch which one's behind and lower back down. Again, repeat, lift, reach out, switch which hand's in front and lower, lift, reach, switch and lower, lift, reach, switch, lower, lift, reach, switch and lower. Lift, reach, hold right here. Hold it for a challenge. For four, squeeze those glutes. Three, two, one, switch and lower. We're gonna do that one more time. Lift, hold and reach. Hold it for four. Make sure your arms aren't too far back. Keep them right to that T-shape. Two and one, switch and lower back down. Coming now onto your forearms, we're gonna do what I call a cat curl. So let's set up properly where our forearms are down and our hips are in what look like a push-up position. They're not all the way pressed back because you're not gonna use your abs. So bring your hips down, okay, and have this nice long feel, head stays long. First, I want you to curl under by squeezing the glutes, it's called an imprint. Now I want you to cat curl into a round shape. Hold this for four, three, two, and one. Now neutral your pelvis and straighten your spine from sacrum to head. Do it again. Squeeze the glutes, imprint the spine, and cat curl hold for four, three, that shaking means your deep core working, and one, neutral pelvis, extend that spine. We've got two more. How are we doing, guys? Imprint, squeeze, they're using their abs. Everything's shaking. Just a little cat curl. Make sure don't lean back here. Hold And back to neutral. We'll do one more here. Make sure you start from that, squeeze the glute in, print that spine, and then walk into your cat curl. Hold it for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Neutral your pelvis. Remember, your last rep is your best one. Finish all your movements. Now go ahead and rest down. Swan will be next. We'll just scoot back a little bit. Elbows by the body, a little wider than your mat. Legs open in a slight turnout. On an inhale, come up for a nice extension to that pubic bone. On an exhale, squeeze the glutes and lift. 3 more. Toes go down, torso goes up. And exhale. Let's show a modification. Go with the hand. Only come up a little bit, okay? Onto that forearm maybe. And lower back down. Remember, legs go down, then torso goes up. And then all the way back down. Lower those legs. Press yourself back into your shell stretch. It's always good to stretch out your low back after you've done a lot of extension. Hold here. Roll out of that one vertebrae at a time. And we're going to go into our side bridge series. So now we've transitioned into our side bridge series. So we're going to do a side bridge off your forearm, knees stacked, and you want to be like a straight line. Envision there's a wall in front of you and you're right up against that wall. So you're going to do a side bridge and we're going to do a low kick with a flexed foot to really drive through your heel and activate that glute. And we're going to lower it back down. This time our leg's going to go a lot higher, as high as we can go, lift, while leading with that heel. If your foot starts to turn out, please lower your leg. Okay, lower it back down. We have 3 more. Shoulder away from the ear. Exhale, press. And lower. Exhale, kick high. And lower. Hand long, not on the hip. And lower. And higher. It's lift. And we have 1 more, and again, a little challenge. Low. Good. And high. You're going to stay in that high. You're going to lower halfway down. You're going to lift to that high. How are we doing? Halfway down. This is hard. And lift. 2 more. It's down. And lift. 1 more. Down. Lift and hold. And lower back down. Bend the knee. Let's switch our sides. We're doing another side exercise, so I want to give you a break on that shoulder. Bend both knees. Shoulder away from the ear. Top arm is long. We're gonna do our side bridge and our low kick again through that heel. Make sure the toe's not pointed up, and then bend. Then our high lift, and lower. It's our low lift. We're doing 4 of each, and lower, and then it's our high. Lead with that heel, and lower. Exhale, lift, and lower. Shoulder away from the ear, and press high, and lower. Last one, it's push, return, and high and hold, and it's lower. Halfway down, press it back up. Halfway down, press it back up. Halfway down, ladies, how are you? And lift, we've got 1 more. These are harder than they look. And it's lift and hold, and it's lower back down. Here's our next side bridge. Switch to the other side. Top leg stacks over, heel to toe squeezing together. Get those inner thighs working, shoulder relaxed back and down, using those muscles of the back. So we're gonna go into our side bridge and hold here. And if you need a break, you can rest down in between. If you wanna challenge yourself, keep up the whole time. Rotate towards the ground to your forearms and hold for 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back to your side position, scoop the arm up and do a side bend. And do it again. You could do this off your full arm, but we have 2 hand supported exercises in the vertical work. So I like to do it off the forearm to balance out that workout so you're not overusing any muscles. Side bend, we've got 2 more. Rotate and hold for 4, 3, breathe 2, and 1. Here it is. Lift, side bend, and last one. 4, 3, 2, 1. Back to side. Lift up, hold, and return. Let's get a little stretch before the other side. Go into your mermaid and stretch away. So we lengthen out the muscles we are just strengthening. Now send your legs out that way. Here we go, cross that top leg over. Forearm down, shoulder away from the ear, abdominals drawn in and up, and side bridge. Remember, you could always rest in between each rep. Rotate and hold for 4. It's 1, two, three, four, side, scoop, and lift. Return. Again, it's one, two, three, four, side bridge, lift. You've got two more. You could always do more reps. I chose four, but you could do eight. You could try one and work up to your four. Back to center, lift, side bridge. Last one, it's one, two, three, four, side, lift, bend, and return. Here's a mermaid. Bring those legs in, switch your legs to the side, side bend over and stretch, and then return. Now our last plank exercise. So we're gonna go into our forearm plank, hip width distance apart. This is what's gonna be the challenge, an off-centered press back off your forearms, which will challenge your triceps. Bring your feet together, your right foot over to your left. You'll be slightly off-center here towards the left. Then press back into your heels using your triceps, draw back over and separate the feet. Bring the left to the right, you're off-centered, and press back. Press in through those heels. Now walk out at the same time. Here's our four at tempo. Together, press back, draw out. Together, press back, widen down. Together, press back, draw. Together, press back. You're on your last two. If you needed a break, take it now. And it's push and draw wide. Together, push back, draw. Keep your neck long, don't look out. Together, don't look this way. Keep that head in alignment with that spine. Last one, guys. We can do it. How we doing? Press back. Hold here for four, three, two, and one. Push up all the way into your plank. Hold, plank, and walk your hands to your feet. And roll it up.